Today we're going to be 3D sculpting Mewtwo in VR using Shapelab Lite on Meta Quest 3.
While Shapelab is installing, just a quick disclaimer to say that the developers have given me a free copy of this, but it's not a sponsored video. This is just my initial reactions to see how intuitive it is without any prior knowledge.
All right, we have a ball. And already, if you're used to any VR app to grab, you'll feel right at home.
Go standard. All right. Just using the joystick can change the brush side and the strength as well. This feels quite natural. And it's just nice to have all the labels as you hover each of the icons. Right, so I'm just playing around here, just seeing how it works before I actually get stuck into actually making something proper.
You have no idea what you're doing.
Tentacle. Ooh, that's quite fun. Got stamp.
Oh, nice. On the left controller joystick, pushing left, I've accidentally found the undo function.
I'm gonna use this a lot.
See, I'm using this for the first time without any tutorial. I just wanna see how intuitive it is. So I'm kind of fumbling about a bit. I'm not quite sure what some of the buttons do.
Please, no, don't push the button.
This is not how I normally do things, but I wanna try something different this time. And it's, you know what, it's just kind of nice to play, figure things out, not always have to watch a tutorial to see how things work.
Because I'm learning Unreal Engine at the moment, and progress is much slower as it's very technical. And with that, I've watched hours of tutorials lately. So it's quite refreshing just to dive in. Having said that, I probably could benefit from some of Shapelab's tutorials just to get the most out of it.
There's a menu button on the joystick, so if I press into it, it brings that up, and I can actually grab it and move it around as well. But I'm getting a really good idea of how this all works now.
Okay, let's see if I can change my environment background.
Well, there we go. Yeah, this is really handy to use the pass-through mode. So in mixed reality, I can actually just see all my surroundings and make sure I don't knock into this one here. Check out my reference material I've got. Have some water without making a mess.
Now, can I add a reference image? Yep, it's not the right one, but good to know it works.
All right, we've got a new scene. I'm gonna load up my reference image.
This image I put together earlier in Photoshop and export it as a PNG.
Let me double check. I can do some kind of symmetry mode. Oh, there we go. Looking more like a bear at the moment, but let's keep at it. Good that I can just change the size up depending on how I want to look at it. There's quite a few different tools here, but actually just the sculpt tool on its own seems to be working for me right now. So why did I pick Mewtwo to create? Well, I wanted to create some kind of creature character. I didn't have anything of my own ready, but I thought let's try a Pokemon. And I could have tried Pikachu, but he's a bit simple.
So I thought, why not Mewtwo? He'll provide the right level of challenge. And yeah, I am finding it a bit of a challenge right now. More from my own ability than anything else, but it's enjoyable.
The interesting challenge here is I'm using 2D references for a 3D model. I haven't got a whole 360 reference, but this is all part of the fun.
At this point here, it's been about 45 minutes.
Okay, so we're back. I've taken a little break because my eyes were getting a little fatigued from the VR. So I'm not quite used to spending so much time in one go.
It's actually not a bad thing to have a break, to then come back with fresh eyes to see where I'm going wrong with the skinny rat.
What are you talking about?
But it's fine. It's all part of the process. We can be fine.
The ears look more like they belong to Shrek.
Oh!
yeah. He looks a bit like Predator at the same time, doesn't he?
One
ugly mother...
Sculpture needs a lot more work, which I think you'll agree.
This is a cool feature, so you can increase the polygon based on what you're working on. By the face, you need a lot more detail, whereas some of the other sections probably need less polygons.
I need to sort this very sad deflated balloon tail.
Balloons make me very happy.
I'm going to model him in the classic T pose, because I'm going to import him into another program later to animate. His hands are a bit big now. Shrink it down a bit.
It looks smaller from the sky.
So this app on the Meta Quest is the light version. So the desktop version on PC VR actually has even more controls, even more features.
There's more.
That's going to be definitely pretty cool to check out, considering this has a lot of tools you need anyway. The hands look slightly different. Looks like the symmetry went off at some point. I'm not too sure how to fix this. There's probably a better way, but I'm just going to just do it manually. Oh, you might be wondering why I've got this yoga mat there. It's not for Mewtwo. In a VR, more so for normal VR without the mixed reality.
It can be disorientating figuring out your physical position in the real world, but with this yoga mat, there's a tactile reference point. So if you're not on the yoga mat, you're probably venturing too close to the furniture or that TV over there. For Mewtwo's outer vein, let's use this donut.
Donuts.
There we go.
Now onto some painting.
We had a little break because we needed to recharge some batteries and download some of the footage as well because we're running out of space. It got a bit dark outside, but it's okay. We've got some new lights and we are back. Just want to add some detail to the eyes area.
Yeah, I need more work on these ears to make them less like a rabbit. Or as they say in Japanese, Usagi.
Usagi!
Usagi.
Usagi.
Usagi!
You're soggy!
I love how the shape tool is emitting some light and actually reflects off the 3D model, like it's giving him some superpowers.
For me, okay. Sure.
Okay, back to painting. There's not a huge amount of color variation on Mewtwo, but what I do is actually just darken some of the contours just to help accentuate the 3D structure. It's good to see that you can actually have a range of different ways of selecting the color. Let's have a bit of fun. Let's see if we can get some glowing eyes. And there we have it, Mewtwo sculpted and painted in Shapelab.
Woohoo!
So I can see I've nearly used 160,000 polygons to create Mewtwo here, which is well under the recommended 1.5 million polygons. So the Quest can definitely handle a lot more than this.
We've got a wide range of 3D export formats.
But before we leave Shapelab, here's a quick summary of my experience.
No prior knowledge is needed, so it's quick to get started.
And the learning curve is much faster than the industry standard ZBrush. The MetaQuest version has a comprehensive tool list.
A feature-rich desktop version is available for creators who need PC power to handle even more polygons.
And it even has a mixed reality mode.
There's a perpetual license for both Quest and desktop versions, because who wants another subscription?
On the cons,
there's no recall of your VR layout, so your setup will change if you take a headset on or off or go into the main Meta menu. There's only a small paintbrush library,
but in future releases, the developers will consider this.
but you can add custom ones right now. And lastly, to end on a positive, there are multiple file export options which popular 3D editing software can import, which segues onto the next stage of my creative flow beyond Shapelab. But as this is not the main focus of this video, I'll be skimming over my process in Cinema 4D and in Unreal Engine. I went with a FBX file export. This was imported into Cinema 4D. Here I rigged the model, did a hula test.
But Ginger, I can't do that.
Then it was ready to be animated. The idea is Mewtwo has just escaped his glass confinement chamber. He then uses his psychic abilities to push the glass.
So as he walks, he doesn't step on the shards.
Cinema 4D's physics simulation and cloner tools help with the animation. The native plugins between Cinema 4D and Unreal Engine were not behaving properly for me, so I opted to export an Alembic file to Unreal Engine instead. I chose Unreal Engine because I wanted to make use of the real-time rendering of this software. Plus, I've got a more comprehensive library of 3D assets I've purchased for Unreal to help build out my environment faster. Next was some lighting treatment. I combined the texture I painted in Shapelab with the bump and normal maps of a leather texture, allowing the lighting to interact with the material more realistically, giving Mewtwo a more intense look. Then I added a light source and VDB nebula effect for his powers, set up some cameras, and then rendered. The final editing was done in Premiere, where the sound design completed the video.